This diary will contain all the topics for network theory. So please listen and see carefully. All the best.
So today we will start with topic 10 only. But it will be, you will say topic 10 part 2, okay? Topic 10. In previous video, we discussed series interconnection. And in this video, I will name it as part 2. We will discuss parallel interconnection. Okay. So let us recall, what do you mean by parallel? So parallel means, like we all know, I will take current source here. So parallel means when the elements have common node. Just remember this line and you will never confuse in finding out what is parallel and what is series. Okay. So this is common pair of node. Okay, IS R1, R2, R3, R4. So see, these all elements R1, R2, IS, R3, R4 have common node. This is common node. Okay. So what that means, that, and please remember, it is the elements should have a common pair of node. Common pair, this means two nodes should be common. So one node is this and one node is this. Okay, so I will write this statement. So two elements are said to be in parallel if they share a common pair of node. Two elements are said to be in parallel if they share a common pair of node. So what is the common pair of node here? See, this is one node and this is second node. So this is common. Just for understanding, I hope you understand this. And we all know how to find the parallel resistance. Let me say, if it is A, it is B. So I have to find RAB, the resistance as seen from here. So what it will be? It will be R1 parallel, R2 parallel, R3 parallel, R4. So we all know how to find this. 1 upon RAB is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Plus 1 upon R4. Okay, and we all know that 1 upon RAB is, can also be written as GAB. G is conductance. Okay, reciprocal of resistance is conductance, and 1 upon R1 can be G1, similarly G2, G3, and G4. So we can write it simply like this. So always in parallel connection, we know voltage across each element remains same. So in parallel connection, we always talk about what? It's common sense that we will talk about current only. So in parallel connection, that's why I have taken current source here, because in parallel connection we talk about current. Now let me come to the main point, that is current division rule. What happens in current division rule is, now let me say I have to find out current across this resistance. So let me set it I1. So I1 will be given by G1 upon total 4 resistances, G2 plus G3 plus G4 into what? IS. Okay. See, this is the general expression. But usually, like it is, it can be used generally. Usually in questions where we have only two resistances, we can directly apply this formula. See, this is I want to find out current. This is I1, this is I2. So I1 can be directly written as, see, if we have to find across R1 the current, then you will write the other resistance in the numerator, that is R2 upon R1 plus R2 into total current IS. Similarly, I have to find I2. So I will write R1 in numerator into IS. So this is valid. We can not valid with this, we can write directly for two resistance parallel combination. Okay. But when there are many parallel combinations, then we have to remember this. Like we write in form of conductance. Okay. You can write this also in the form of conductance. After solving, you will get this only. So this is kind of a trick and you should remember this. Okay, so this is all about the current division rule. Okay, always remember those formulas. And please remember that when there is, what is the parallel connection? When the elements have a common pair of node. Okay, pair of node. So now we will see parallel interconnection of sources. Parallel interconnection of sources. So let us first take the voltage source. So if I am taking a voltage source, then let me say this is V1 plus minus and this is V2 plus minus. I have taken these voltage sources and this is the load R. So here, so in previous video also I have told you one thing, that at any point of time in a circuit, if KVL or KCL are not valid, are not satisfying, then the circuit is not valid. So this you have to understand. So here let us take first case. Let us say that V1 is equal to V2. Then if I apply KVL in this loop, then what will be KVL? V1 minus V2 is equal to 0 and V1 is equal to V2. So this is satisfying. KVL is satisfied. So we can connect, what we found out from this discussion, that we can connect two voltage sources in parallel. Okay, we could connect two voltage sources in parallel if their magnitude is same. If their magnitude is same. Now let us say, let us take another case, if V1 not equal to V2. So now apply KVL in this loop. V1 minus V2 is equal to 0 by KVL, but V1 is not equal to V2. So this is not valid. So KVL is not satisfied. So this means that we can't connect two voltage sources in parallel if their magnitudes are not same. Simple discussion. Okay, now we will see what will happen when we connect the sources. What sources? Current sources in parallel. So let me take these two current sources, 5 ampere and 4 ampere. Now simple, like we will apply KCL here, 5 plus 4, 9 amperes. So this is a valid circuit. We could connect two current sources in parallel. Simple. As they are satisfying KCL. Okay. Now let me revert the polarity of this. So okay. So now if you apply KCL here, what will happen? I will come out to be 1 ampere. Then also we can apply KCL. So this circuit is a valid circuit. So we could connect current sources in parallel in any way, like with opposite signs also and with same sign also. Sign, you understand what I'm talking about. Okay, this. So simple. Only we could not connect the voltage sources in parallel if their magnitude is not same, because they won't satisfy KVL. Now let us understand one important trick, you say, or you say an observation, or you can better say it observation. Okay, so what is the observation is, like there is a current source of 5 volt. Let me take numbers. Numbers are easy to understand. Eh? And this is 5 ohms. And this is the RL. RL is, what RL is? RL is load. So what you have to do is, now I am saying find out this VL, find out this IL, and find out power also across, power dissipated across load, that is VL into IL. So similar, I have taken similar kind of discussion for the current source also in previous video. Now let us analyze. See, we have to find these three things. So, and RL is also given to us. RL is, let us say, 5 ohms. Okay. So what will be VL? You can easily find out, it will be 5 volts. Simple. It's parallel connection. What will be IL? For IL, we have to find out, IL will be the voltage drop across, this is VL. VL by RL. So VL by RL will be 5 by 5. That is 1 ampere. And PL will be what? VL into IL, 5 into 1. That will be 5 ohms. So what I am trying to say by this discussion is that we can easily neglect this 5 ohm resistor or any resistor connected in parallel with the source if we are only interested in finding out the parameters across the load. See, just please rewind this video a little bit and please listen to my statement once again. Okay, so I could repeat it again. A resistance in parallel with voltage source can be neglected for load parameter calculations only. Because I hope you get this. We can easily neglect if it's not given 5 ohm, if it is given R. So it doesn't matter. I can easily calculate IL, VL, and PL all. Again, I don't need this R. So that is what I'm trying to say. That you can easily neglect the any resistance connected in parallel across the voltage source if you are only interested in finding out parameters across the load. Okay. So I hope you get this observation. Just keep this in mind and it will be helpful in solving questions fast. So, okay. Thank you guys. Please keep sharing and watching these videos. And this video is a part of playlist known as Network Theory Diary. So please go through that diary and all each and every topic that I have covered till now. Okay. Thank you. Keep sharing.